पार्ट 56 कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ डायरेक्टिंग। फर्स्ट वी कैन रिकलेक्ट द मीनिंग ऑफ डायरेक्टिंग। डायरेक्शन मीन्स टू गेट द वर्कर्स, मेक दम अवेयर ऑफ द वर्क, सुपरवाइज दम एंड टू मेंटेन देयर एंथुसियाज्म फॉर द वर्क। अकॉर्डिंग टू कून्स एंड ओडोनल, डायरेक्शन इज द एक्सिक्यूटिव फंक्शन ऑफ गाइडिंग एंड observing subordinate. In this part we can study about different characteristics of directing. First one, goal oriented activity. The purpose of direction is to guide and motivate the employees, which leads to achievement of business objectives. Thus direction is a goal oriented activity. The purpose of direction is to guide and motivate the employees for the achievement of predetermined goal of the organization. Thus direction is a goal oriented activity. And second one, function at every level of management. Direction is the function of management at all levels. Top level managers direct departmental officers regarding target, policy and administrative matters. In the same manner, at the bottom level, supervisors give orders and instruction to the foreman and jobbers, while jobbers and foreman direct the workers working under their control. Thus direction moves from top level to the bottom level of management. Directing take place at every level of management. Every manager from the top executive to supervisors perform the function of directing. Directing is a persistent function as it is performed by managers at all levels and in all locations. Directing flows from a top level of administration to the base level or bottom level. The directing take place wherever superior subordinate relation exists. Every manager has to administer, direct, inspire and communicate with his subordinate to get things done. Every manager exercises this function on his instantaneous subordinates. However, the time spent in directing is moderately more at the operational level of management, means direction more function at the bottom level or functional or operational level of management. Third one, continuous process. Directing is a continuous process. As long business activities will continue, the function of direction will also continue. Direction is provided to the employees regarding functions, procedures and interpretation of policy. Thus direction is a continuous process. Directing is a continuous activity. Directing is a constant procedure. A manager cannot just rest after issuing orders and instructions. It takes place throughout the life of the organization, irrespective of people occupying managerial positions. It is a continuous function as it continues all over the life of organization, irrespective of the changes in the managers or employees. He must constantly take steps to make sure that orders and instructions are considered out accurately. And fourth one, observation of function. The purpose of direction is to see that employees are working as per direction given to them or not. Direction is not merely the process of guiding and giving orders, but it is a process of observing whether work is done as per order or instruction or not. The objective of providing direction is to ensure whether employees are working as per direction or not. Otherwise,
any deviation is the corresponding officers want to check and correct them to make it its proper way. Direction is not simply the process of issuing orders and guidance, but also it is the process of supervising whether the work is executed as per given instructions and orders or not, and checking whether the employees are doing as per the instructions or not. And fifth one, wider scope. Scope of direction is wider. It is not merely guiding and advising to the employees, but the manager has to provide understanding of decisions and to put the efforts for its implementation. Direction does not mean simply providing guidance and advices. It is a continuous process, and it is regarding giving proper understanding about the decisions taken by the managers about the organization, and further to ensure that the decisions are effectively implemented or not, and efforts are directed towards the same. So we can say direction has wide scope. And sixth one, communication. Effective communication is a precondition to give orders and a guide to the employees in direction. If communication process is not effective, it is difficult to give the right direction to the right employee at the right time. In direction or guidance giving time, there is a precondition that to provide guidance and orders to employees, there has to be appropriate efficient communication system. It is a part of formal communication system. If communication process is not proper, then it will not be possible to provide at the right time to right employees the right guidance. So effective communication in a formal way that will affect the better implementation of various policies and decisions of the top level management. So communication is a very important process, and it will lead to the achievement of organizational goal, and it will reduce the deviations. And seventh one, motivation. It is necessary to motivate the employees. In order to extract the best efforts from them, higher authorities give personal guidance to motivate the employees. Such guidance solves the problems and doubt of the employees, generates faith in them, therefore they motivate to do better work. Directing is regarding about the human element. Since all employees are dissimilar and perform differently in dissimilar situations, it becomes significant for the managers to undertake the situations properly. The directing function involves revise and molding of human behavior. Thus, directing is an important function that gets the work done by the employees and increases the enlargement of the organization. It motivates employees to work with their best capabilities. Eighth one, flow of direction. Direction is a downward process. It always moves from top level to bottom level management. Top level management gives guidance to the managers of middle level management, and middle level management directs the workers of the bottom level management. Directions are given by managers to their subordinate. Directing is the first initiated at the top level and flows to the bottom through the organizational hierarchy. Means top level to middle level to the bottom level. Every manager can direct his instant subordinate and take directions from the directors. It means that every manager can direct his immediate subordinate and take instructions from his immediate officer or managers. Directing starts from top level and flows to the lower level or bottom level. And ninth one, it is a managerial function. Direction is a part of management like various other functions such as planning, organizing, staffing, coordinating, communication and controlling. The function of direction is linked to various functions of the management like planning, organizing, staffing, coordinating, communication and controlling. We can say after function of planning, organizing and staffing, direction going to start. Without direction, other management function going to absent. So direction is the one of the important managerial function. In this part, we discussed about characteristics of directing. First characteristics, it is a goal-oriented activity. Second one, function at every level of management. Third, continuous process. Fourth one, observation of function. Fifth one, wide scope. Sixth one, communication. Seventh one, motivation. Eighth one, flow of direction. And ninth one, managerial function.